In this illustration, we intend to simulate the square dip drawing in the Abaqus software. This model is composed of punch, holder, sheet, and die. And since there is a symmetry in the model, we will simulate 1/4 of that. And you can observe 1/4 of the model in the left picture and the complete one in the right picture. In the deep drawing process, first the sheet is set on the die, then the holder part will be placed on the sheet. Following that, a determined force will be applied to the holder, causing the sheet to hold still. The force of the blank holder should be appropriate because if the force applied is too much, the punch force will be increased and finally causes the sheet to be sheared. And if the force applied is less than normal, the sheet will be wrinkled. In the next step, punch will be set on the sheet, then slide downward and causes the sheet to get into shape. You can also observe the deformation of the sheet in this picture. In the next step, I will enter holder part into the assembly section. Click on Translate Instance, select Holder, Done. First select this point and then this one and OK. I'll enter Interaction Module. Here we should define the interaction between different parts. Here we should define the interaction between sheet and punch, sheet and holder, as well as sheet and die. To do so, I'll first click on Create Interaction Property. Here I intend to define interaction properties between the sheet and punch. Continue. I will select tangential behavior from the mechanical menu and then penalty. The coefficient of friction between the sheet and punch is 0.25 and OK. Again, I will click on create interaction property. First, I intend to define the interaction between the sheet and die. Continue. Here, I will select the hole of die, done, and here select their surface which is in contact with the sheet. So here I select the purple color, click on surface, click on invert display, select the sheet and done. I will select the bottom surface of the sheet that is in purple color. Here select sheet die and OK. Then I select this edge of the sheet, done, select boundary condition of X symmetric for it and OK. I will click on create boundary condition once again, select displacement rotation. Here select the step 1 and continue. I will select the reference point of punch, done. I will click on assign mesh control, select the holder, done. Here select the sweep and quad and OK, and finally click on mesh part and yes. Select ODB display option and then tick on render shell thickness option. In this manner you can observe the thickness of the sheet. Here I will remove the punch part from the model so you can observe the process of analysis of model much better. Then I'll select CSYS1 from here, tick on YZ and XZ options and apply. Here the complete view of the model can be observed. Here I will first remove the holder part from the model so we can observe the process of analyzing the model in a better way. You can also observe the deformation from the bottom section of the model. In the next step, I'll remove the punch part. Here I'll select the equivalent plastic strain. As you observe, the most quantity of the strain can be found in this area that has been displayed by red color. In the next step, I'll remove die part from the model. Here you can observe the final shape of the sheet at the end of the deep drawing process. I will select the STH parameter or the same sheet thickness. As it can be observed here, the least quantity of thickness is in this area, having been displayed by blue color, and its quantity is equal to 0.68 millimeters. In the next step, I'll calculate the amount of force having been applied to the punch. To do so, I'll click on Create XY Data, then ODB Field Output and Continue. From here, I will select Unique Nodal, then RF3, click on Edit Selection, select this node, and click on Plot. And here the force having been applied to the punch can be observed. Operate on XY data and continue. Here I'll select Combine, then select U3 and then RF3. I will put one negative sign here and one here and click on Plot and Save. Here you can see the diagram of the force having been applied to the punch versus punch displacement. Actually, this is the force applied to the punch itself and then through the punch to the whole sheet, causing that to be deformed. In fact, this is the force which is extremely needed so that complete deformation can be applied to the sheet.